Welcome you students, have a question from isometric projection. A cone of base diameter 50 mm and height 70 mm stands on HP with its base. It is cut by a cutting plane inclined at 30 degree to HP. Cutting the axis of the cone at a height of 40 mm from its base. Draw the isometric view of the remaining part of the cone. Okay, let us take the given data. What about the object is a cone, its diameter is given as 50 mm. So that, what about the radius? It's 25 mm. Okay, and height of the cone is given, axis height, which is 70 mm, right? Fine. And what about the cutting plane or section plane? What's the condition? Cutting plane inclined 30 degree to HP, and cutting the axis of the cone at a height 40 mm. It is cutting the axis 40 mm from its base. Okay, so we need to draw the isometric view. So this is a given task for us, right? So first of all, when you want to draw the isometric view, we need to start with the orthographic view, that means top view and front view, for the simple portion, right? Here is the cone, always in the isometric projection we need to take the simple position by keeping the base on HP, just keeping the object vertical. Okay, just keeping the object on HP, right? So here in the question itself given, suppose if it is not given, you need to take the base on HP. Okay, remember it. Take a reference line XY, it's a cone. In the top view we shall see the true shape of the object. So that is circle. Take 25 mm radius in your compass and keeping at a point, just go for a circle. So that this circle will be like this. It is circle like this manner. So as this manner, this circle will be formed. Okay. Now divide this circle into 4 equal parts through the center. First of all, I'm going to have the vertical line through the center, and then have a horizontal line through the center, so that the circle is divided into 4 equal parts. Again, take this as A, B, C, and this is D. What is next? The front view. So take the projector from each and every points from the base, intersect with the XY line. Okay, axis height is given, so take the axis 70 mm, raise it up and have 70 mm in your compass, and have a cut mark so that you can specify a point which is apex O. In the top view we mention it as O, and in the front view we can mention it as O dash. If we connect the apex with the base, shall form the triangular face of the cone in the front view. So when you are looking from the front, A, B, C will be visible. A dash, B dash, C dash will be a visible one. D will be an invisible one. D is invisible one. Take it inside the bracket nearby B, D dash. Okay, fine. So first of all, you should not make any dark lines since we have cutting plane. Okay, after having the cutting plane, we can come to conclusion which portion is a remained one and which portion is a removed one. Okay, fine. So cutting plane is given 30 degree inclined to HP. So something like this the inclination is. So in the front view, the cut gonna happen, right? So 30 degree inclined to HP and 40 mm from its base. From its base, base is here. This is the base of the cone. So take 40 mm from the base and just have a mark somewhere here, you'll get it. Okay. And now, somewhere here you get it. Now keep your protractor by having a horizontal line. Measure 30 degree and go for a inclined line like this. Okay. At both ends, you need to specify with a thick line. Thick line, dot and thick line. When a cutting plane cuts the object, we know the portion between the cutting plane and the observer is a removed one, removed one. The below region is a remained one, so that we can make dark line for the newly formed top base. Okay, so make the portion as a dark one. This is dark one and this is dark one. Give naming, give the name for the newly cutting points. Here between O dash to A dash, there is a cut point. Here we have only one generator line, so that I'm going to give a one cutting point, that is one dash. Now come to the next position between O to B here and between O to D dash. Here we have two cutting points. One is a visible one. Between O to B dash is a visible one. So for that I'm going to give two dash. And the same place we have the invisible generator line. Okay, so that for that I'm going to give the brackets. I'm not giving the names. And then come to the next position here. Here we have a cut point between O dash to C dash. It's a visible one. So I'm going to give three dash. After completing all the visible, come in reverse to mark the invisible point. So here we have only one invisible point. 1, 2, 3 we have given. So this would be 4 dash. 4 dash is given for the cutting point between O dash to D dash. Right? Fine. So this is the cut section for the front view. Okay. So come to the top view. When you have a cut, definitely it forms the new base. So it should be represented on the top view. Okay. So in order to draw the top view, take the projector from each and every cut point and just intersect with the same generator line. So one is between O to A. So take a projector and intersect with O to A. So you got a intersection point, it would be 1. Then move to the second one. Second and 4, it is been O dash and B dash, between O to D dash. Am I right? If you take a projector, this will pass through the line, but we cannot get an intersection point, right? When you get the projector, it passes through the line. We couldn't able to identify the intersection point. What we have to do is, in such occasion, we need to bring the line in the front view to the left extreme generator line. Okay, so you need to get the horizontal line, something like this, you get it. Okay, so this is the line. After getting it, bring it to the top view with very good thin line, and which should be a 90 degree line, and just intersect with O to A. In order to specify, take your compass and measure the distance O to and its particular point, and go for an arc or go for a semicircle like this, with the center O. And we had a cut point between O to B. O to B, it's 2, right? So name it as 2. And between O to D, we had a cut. Here O to D, we have cutting point 4. So this would be your 4. Okay. And next, move to the third one. It is easy. It is between O to C. O to C is here. Take a projector, intersect it, so that you will get that point. Okay, we got 1, 2, 3 and 4. All the 4 points have specified. Now, if you connect one another with a free hand, without any scale, okay, if you connect it, you will get the shape in the top view. Once you got the shape, you can go for a dark one. Go for a dark one. It's a top base, and this is the bottom base. You are looking from the top base and bottom base of the truncated cone will be visible. So make both of the base as a dark one. It's a sectioned region, so that we need to give a hatching. We know hatching should be given with a line 45 degree inclination and with the spacing 3 mm. Okay, we need to give equal spacing of 3 mm. Okay, next, till now we have completed the section front view and sectional top view. What is next? Our task is isometric view, right? Isometric view for this truncated cone. How will you make the isometric view? So first we need to have the horizontal line, then by keeping a midpoint, just keep your protractor something like this and read 30 degree. Okay, all the lines in the isometric are 30 degree and 90 degree lines, so at right and left have to read 30 degree line and get the line something like this at the right and left. Okay, it is a unconditional line. Okay, be ready with this. Okay, both the lines are 30 degree. Orthographic projection concern, all the lines are 90 degree and 0 degree, and here this isometric view concern, all the lines are 30 degree and 90 degree. Okay, fine. In order to make this cone into isometric view, we follow the box method, so that in order to make the box, we going to form the boundary for the this circle in the top view. So for that, you have to take the tangent line and the extreme portion. I have taken it for the left and right, then the bottommost, go for a tangent line, and in the topmost, go for a tangent line, so that you could get the boundary. Name it as 1, 2, 3, and 4 in Roman letter, like this manner. First, just transfer this boundary to the isometric axis. I'm gonna take this point as 1. This point as 1. Concentrate on 2, for which take the measurement 1 to 2. Keeping at 1, have a cut mark in a 30 degree line. So you get the second. Take the measurement 1 to 4. Keeping at 1, have a cut mark, so that you get 4th point. Now it's a third one, final point, right? So just take the measurement from 4 to 3. What is the measurement? Keeping at 4, have a cut mark. And from 2 to 3, take the measurement, and keeping at 2, have a cut mark. So somewhere here you get the the intersection point. This would be your that. Make the connections. When you are doing it, the line 1 to 4 and 2 to 3 will be a parallel, and the line 1 to 2 and 3 to 4 will be a parallel line. Fine. Think about this base point A, B, C, and D, where it is been placed on the boundary. Am I right? A is between 1 and 4. In order to specify it, take the measurement 1 to A. The measurement, keeping at 1, have a cut, so that you get A. Where is B? It is between 1 to 2. Take the measurement 1 to B. What is the measurement? Have a cut mark in the respective boundary line. You get capital B. Where is C? It is between 2 to 3. 2 to 3 is here. Take the measurement 2 to C. What is the measurement? Keeping at 2, have a cut. This would be C. Where is D? It is between boundary line 3 to 4. 3 to 4. Take a measurement from 3, convey it. So this would be D. What is the method follow in the isometric view or isometric projection to conclude the shape of the circle? It's a four-centered method. Okay, how will you do it? Concentrate on one. From the opposite midpoints or opposite centers, bring a line to it. Bring a line to it like this. And then concentrate on three. From the opposite midpoint or centers, bring a line to it. From A and B, take a line to that Roman letter. What is next? Take your compass, keep one as center and make read the radius 1 to D and have a arc. Keep a compass on the 3 and read the radius 1 to A and go for a arc. Then when you got the cross lines, you got two centers at the mid. If I take this as 1 and 2, keeping at 1, read the radius 1 to D in your compass and have a arc so that you get the arc something like this. Then go to the second. Keep at 2 and take the radius 2 to C and go for a arc. So it would be like this. Okay. Now the base shape has been taken into the isometric view. Okay. You need to specify the top. How will you specify the top? See, in order to specify it, we need to take all the points to the extreme boundary. Okay, in order to specify the exact measurement, we need to take the line, horizontal line, to the extreme boundary, either in the left side or in the right side. I am going to take in the left side. So from the second point, here is the second point. So I am going to take a horizontal line and intersecting with the boundary line. Okay, so I am going to take this as P. P, in order to specify, I am going to take this as P. And from the first and 3, 1 and 3 is in the same line. So I am taking it. So here is the Q. Q, small letter Q. Here is 4, taking the horizontal line, intersecting with the boundary. I'm going to take this as R. Okay. The same thing should be taken over the boundary 1 to 4, between the boundary line 1 to 4. Okay, take the measurement 1 to P. What is the measurement? Keeping at 1, have a cut mark, you will get P. Take the measurement 1 to Q. From 1, just have a cut mark. So somewhere here, you get what? Q. Okay. And then, where is R? Take the measurement 1 to R and have a cut mark. Somewhere here, you get it. So this would be R. This would be R. Now take the same horizontal line. Okay. Here when you are taking the horizontal line, you should take a line parallel to the boundary line. Parallel to the boundary. These lines are parallel to which line? Boundary line 1 to 2 and 4 to 3. Am I right? Similar manner, how to take a parallel line between 1 to 2 and 4 to 3. Okay. So I am going to take a parallel line. So this is how the parallel lines will be. This is how the parallel lines will be. Then, in order to specify 1, 2 and 1, 2, 3 and 4, take the measurement, that means take the depth of it, depth of the line. So from P to 2, I am going to take the measurement and keeping at P, I am going to transfer it so that I get 2. Take the measurement 1 from Q, the depth, and keeping at Q, just transfer it so that I will get 1. 3 is in the same Q line. From Q, take the measurements of it and keeping at Q, just transfer it so that you get somewhere here the 3. Where is 4? In the line R. Take the measurement R to 4 in the same OR line, just have a cut mark so that you get 4. So I have specified it in the bottom base, but it's a top base, right? So top base height can be taken from the front view. So in order to specify it, take a vertical line or 90 degree line each and from each and every selected points in the bottom base. So just raise it up with the unconditional manner, okay? Afterwards, take a perpendicular distance from the front view. Always the width or length can be taken from the what, top view. If you are in it with the height, you need to take the height from the front view, okay? So we are just working with the front view now, working with the height. So we have to take the measurement from the front view. So in order to specify the one from the base, perpendicular distance to be measured. Perpendicular distance, not the slant distance. It should be a perpendicular from the base. Measure the one, and keeping at one, have a cut mark so that you get the final place for one. This is the final one. And then what about two? Here it is. Take the perpendicular distance. 2 and 4 is the same measurement. Okay, from 2 have a cut mark. So somewhere here you get it. And for the 4, from the same place, if you have a cut somewhere here, you get it. Somewhere here, you get it. Now what about 3? Take the perpendicular distance. Keeping at 3, have a cut mark. So somewhere here, get a point. Okay. So now just trace out the curve by having a line 1 to another. 1 to 2, I gonna have the line, and 3 to 2, okay, and 3 to 4, and 4 to 1. When you're having it, you'll get the ellipse shape at the top. So this is the top base, okay. After concluding it, you need to specify the visible portion, okay. So for that, always in the isometric, we need to come from the top. So top base always a visible one. So make the top base as a dark one. As a dark one. Okay. And then come to the left and right extreme. Take a tangent line from the top base and connect it with the bottom base. Bottom base. Tangently to it. From the right extreme, take a line tangent to the top base and connect it to the bottom base tangentially. Somewhere in the bottom base, it connected. The front face region between the left extreme and right extreme is a visible one. So I'm going to take this curve as a dark one. It's a dark one. Okay. Only in the isometric view, the visible portion should be drawn as a dark one. All the other things are a construction line. Okay, so you need to do all the construction line with very thin manner. Okay, and this is a sectioned surface, so that you need to give hatching. So take a 45 degree incline line with a gap 3 mm. Have a hatching like this. Okay, so I hope you understood. And when you are coming to the part of pyramid, when you have the section something like this in the inclined manner, the same manner you will get the new top base for the pyramid. Okay, at that time too, you need to follow the similar procedure in order to specify the top base. Okay, you need to bring all the corner point to the right or left extreme and take the measurement and convey it to the isometric view and take a perpendicular line and have a height and just form the top base. Okay, have completed it, and the measurement is the important part here. Okay, so what about the base measurement? The diameter is given as 50 mm. Okay, so take the leader line So for that, I'm going to take a cross line, okay, the filled arrows, and take a leader line, something like this, and write above it diameter 50, okay, in a neat manner, you can make it. And then height of the cone is 70 mm, so that take the height as 70 mm, and then the cutting plane inclination and the height is given. Cutting plane inclination is 30 degrees, so here I going to mark it, so mark it as 30 degrees. It is taken from the base 40 mm away from the base, right? So mark from the base, just have a parallel line to the axis and write above the line as 40 mm, as 40 mm. What is next? Next is a note. All dimensions are in mm. It's the isometric view, okay, just note it down. It's the isometric view, okay, it's not a isometric projection. If the question is asked with isometric projection, you need to stamp with a isometric scale, just a graphical one, okay. So here it's an isometric view, so just write the scale 1:1, actual scale 1:1. Take a note, all dimensions are in mm, okay, all dimensions or in mm. Okay, I hope you understood. Thank you so much.